Hey guys, how you guys doing? It is Tuesday, February 19th, 2019. Hoping you're having a wonderful day, guys. A blessed day indeed. A few things I wanted to talk about today. Hey guys, second video in under a week. I think it's been under a week. I'm adjusting myself here real quick. A couple things I wanted to talk about. Of course, we want to talk about Venezuela. Some updates to that. You know, the big date is February 23rd, that's happening this Saturday, to see what happens with this humanitarian aid. You know, do we see Maduro's military lay down their arms, let it come through? You know, highly unlikely at this point. The head of the defense minister of Venezuela stated that they fully support Maduro and that we would have to go over their dead bodies to get to them. You know, it's a very sticky situation. I don't see a way out of this, but you know, I talked about in my last video, I don't want to overstretch, you know, and I feel like I did that too many times in previous videos, and I feel like a lot of people on social platforms like YouTube, like Twitter, they do, you know, that their word is law. That they have the final say, that they're some expert on this. And I don't like using the term expert, all right? Because I don't think I'm an expert. I've been wrong plenty of times before. If you go back 6 months, a year, look at some of my videos, I've been right about some stuff. I've been definitely wrong about some stuff. I think we're all just trying to, you know, gather some sort of knowledge, you know, some understanding of the situation, okay? And that's why I love when people comment on these videos and they're like, hey, dude, you know, good job, but hey, this is my perspective. I think this is what's going on. I love reading that stuff, you know, because I do not have all the answers. I used to say that all the time in my videos. I don't have all the answers, and people who tell you they have all the answers, they're usually wrong, all right? But we all have different perspectives. So, you know, if you got a perspective about this whole Venezuela situation, let me know, you know, because It's pretty hairy, you know. Is it all about the oil, you know, or does the United States of America and its politicians, does Marco Rubio truly care about the poor people of Venezuela, you know, because he's down there right now. A bunch of world leaders are going down there. Brazil just came out and stated that they're going to supply some humanitarian aid along with the United States of America. Venezuela's going around and closing down different routes to different countries. It's a very serious situation. They've added more troops to the border. We have to see what happens Saturday. You know, February 23rd, everyone's been talking about that date. That's when the humanitarian aid is supposed to cross into Venezuela. We have to watch that situation unfold, you know? Give me your predictions. Tell me what you think. I think they're my prediction, you know? Take this with a grain of salt, truly, is I don't think that the humanitarian aid is going to get to the border and that Maduro's forces are going to be like, all right, open fire, you know. That's stupid. Doesn't make any sense. They know that this is partially an orchestrated provocation, you know. The United States of America, if their end goal is to get Maduro out, you know, which it is, we know. They go out and say it. They're out there telling us. That's exactly what they would want. They would want some huge travesty like that to occur, because at that point, you know, going in and taking out Maduro, everyone would support it around the world. No one would be like, you know, what are you doing? You know, everyone, you know, would, the general public would be okay with it, all right? So I don't think that's going to occur. Do I think that the aid's going to go through with no, like, you know, no problem? It's going. Maduro's just letting it go. The military's, you know, standing down. That's highly unlikely. All right. The military not backing Maduro, I don't see that occurring. Okay, or at least the majority of the military. I just don't see it happening. You know, I hope that's what happens. I hope that they just let the aid go through. No bloodshed. No one gets hurt. You know. Putting politics aside, we don't want anyone to lose their life, you know? So if the aid could just get through, you know, I that would be fantastic. All right, it's a situation we're going to have to continue to watch. February 23rd, guys. A little update about the whole India-Pakistan thing. We are still on thin ice when it comes to that. The Prime Minister of Pakistan coming out on television today and saying that if India attacks Pakistan, they're not going to think they're going to retaliate, all right? So we need to continue to watch that situation because it is not over, okay? Let's hope that, you know, peace prevails in that part of the region, but India, Pakistan, both nuclear powers do not like each other one bit, all right? Very tense situation there. Okay, more military buildup by Russia around Ukraine. Ukraine seems to think that Russia's planning something. And, I mean, for the past few months, I know I haven't been on here to update you guys or talk about the situation, but for the past few months, this whole Russia-Ukraine thing, it just seems like, you know, if you look at it with the naked eye, looks like it's a standstill. Mainstream media doesn't care about it because, you know, they got an agenda. And Ukraine and Russia, they're not on it right now. Well, Russia is, but for other reasons. But it's looked like it's been a standstill, right? But, you know, when you look further into it, there's been more and more military movements by Russia towards Ukraine, okay? Very tense situation. I still think that if the U.S. does intervene in Venezuela, I think it's a very good theory and thought to think that Russia would invade Ukraine. Tit for tat notion. All right, the USS Donald Cook entered the Black Sea, I think earlier today, maybe yesterday, had a close encounter with a Russian vessel. Basically, the Russian vessel was just tailing it. Very common procedure, right? I feel like when we see stuff like that in the mainstream media, they make a big deal about it. But stuff like that happens all the time, you know? The U.S. will do the same thing to Russian and Chinese vessels, right? Definitely a lot going on. A lot of sparks going off in the world right now, which really has me worried. It really makes me think, yeah, is this it? I don't know. We're going to have to continue to watch the situation. All right, guys, grab a beer, say a prayer, and as always, keep your eyes to the skies. God bless.